Hey everybody, welcome to Chin Fat. In this episode, I'm continuing going over the toolbar in Premiere Pro. And in this episode specifically, I'm going over the type tool in the toolbar here. And this tool is used for creating graphics and titles over your videos. If you don't want to come over with your mouse and click on it, the shortcut shows right here. It is the AT, the letter T, will choose your type tool. You can see that's now blue, so we've chosen the type tool. And the way this functions is you basically move over the video where you want to put the text. So this is the program monitor here showing whatever is in my timeline. So I'm going to move my mouse over this window approximately where I want to set it. You can edit these later on and adjust those and fine tune them. But I'm just going to click somewhere randomly on my screen and click, and it adds a cursor. And now I can start typing in the title that I want to superimpose over this video. Notice when I click on that, it adds this graphic file down here over the top of my video. It puts it on the layer above the video. If you put it like right here in between where there's no video, let me move it this forward and get a space open here. But if you move up here with your type tool and click on that space, there's no video to superimpose it over, so it just puts it on the first layer here. But I can type in Summer Times, the name of my video. And now to adjust this, I can click on my arrow tool here, the selection tool, and it puts a wireframe around the title. And now you have this scale option here. You also have your move option. You can put it in the middle, move it around. You can scale it. But we'll show you how to fine-tune these features here in a moment. So you'll notice where I put the one that doesn't have any video tracks underneath, it puts it down on this track, as I mentioned. And if I go back to this one up here, it puts it on top of the video track. So it will not overwrite the video with it. It'll put it on top of the video. And now you have a title that is superimposed over the video below it. And if you want it just in a blank space like this, just put it there and then it just does it against a black background like this. Now these graphics that are generated here on this file, this treats this file just like it's a video clip. And you can basically do the same thing to this that you can to a video. You can grab the edge and trim it so it's a longer title. So if you want it to last a longer time, you can go to the edge and trim the endpoint and the outpoint to make it a longer video. You can also grab it, move it around like you can a video track. You can also do the cut, copy, and paste. So like Command X, C, and V, or on a PC, that would be Control X, C, and V. If I got the clip selected, you do Command X to cut. And if I move over another video track and do Command V to paste, it'll paste it over that video track right there. So you can move it just the same way you can a regular video track. Another thing that you can do if you want it to fade in and fade out, just like a video track, you can select it and then you hit Command D or Control D on a PC and it will add cross dissolves to both sides and now you have a fade in. When it comes to editing this to make a different look here, you can go up to Window and you can arrange for captions and graphics and it will add this side panel over here on this to the right-hand side called Essential Graphics. And here you're able to edit what you've got selected on the timeline. Right? So now if you wish to edit your text that you've created here, you move up and this under Essential Graphics, this might be the default. It'll show Browse oftentimes. So you just have to go under the Edit tab here. If you go to the Edit tab, Browse is if you're choosing these stock credits that come with Adobe, that come with Premiere Pro. But if you go to Edit, it'll edit the one that you're creating here. Moving down, there's lots of features under here that you can edit. First of all, if I like this centered, I'm going to go, you've got two different types of centering here. You've got centering within the wireframe and then centering on screen, which is under a line. So this is within the box right here. This might show better if I put another, if I put one of these on the bottom here. And you'll notice that this is not centered. It's pushed over to the left. Right now, it's aligned to the left. So if I go down under here and hit this center align text, it centers it within the wireframe there, but it does not center it on screen. So now I can go up and hit my arrow to select it. Keep in mind that that's what you need to do to move this around is you need to, if it's under text, it's going to be editing within the text box here. If you go up and select your arrow, now it puts a wireframe and you can move this thing around on your screen and you can also change the size right there. So if you want it centered on the screen, you've got these alignments over here where you can align it to the right or you can align it to the left. You can align it to the right, you can align it to the top, the bottom, but here is the horizontal alignment right there, and here is the vertical alignment right there, and now that is perfectly centered in the middle of the screen. Down here you also have the fonts you can choose from. You can pull this down and choose any of the fonts that are available, or you can install new fonts, whatever you want to do. If we click on one of those, choose a nice looking font. You can also change the size right here, or you can do that with a wireframe. Go to one of these nodes and drag the size there, or you can just do it right here. Either way works. If you want to make this stand out a little bit more, you can change the color to the text down here under fill. So you click on the white color here and you can choose any color that you want. For doing like summertime, maybe like a nice golden yellow there. Hit okay. And if you want that to stand out a little bit more, you can also do a stroke around it, around the outside. You can do stroke, or you can do a drop shadow. Let's do a drop shadow here really quick. But you can see all the drop shadow that's hanging off there already. You can change the strength of it. You can actually click right here on the shadow and change it. Right now it's set to like a little bit gray. You can set it to all the way to black if you wish. And then this slider is the opacity slider there. It makes it come and go. You've got a distance slider right here. Then you have a size for your shadow. And then you also have a feather here at the bottom to make it look like it's nice and soft there. If you don't want to drop shadow and you want to do a stroke is an outline basically. And then you can change the size of your outline right here. This is the pixel size right here. So you've got 4 pixel outer stroke there. So if you make this small, let's go to 2, make it just kind of a subtle one. Then you can just click on this and make it dark if you want to. Now you've got a title that basically that stands out a little better. And finally, let's show the layers here that you can add to a single graphic file. So this is the single graphic file right there, but you can add multiple text files inside that one file here. So the way I usually do it is just right click up here and say duplicate. And then you'll see it, seemingly nothing has happened, but it has it's just done a duplicate. You can grab this now and move it off, and then you can do multiple text items on the same screen here. So now this one I can change if I want to. Winter times. Going to do all the seasons. Now remember, once I type in my new title here, you go up to the arrow, and now I can select this and move it around. I can change the colors to it. Ooh, let's make it a nice cool blue for winter times. There we go. And a little bit brighter. Make it look wintry. There we go. And now that's on the same title right there. If you don't want to do that, if you want to have different graphics fading in at different times, you could actually grab this. Once you have, you've created a text file, you can basically just copy and paste this, or you can hold down Option or Alt on a PC. It's Option on a Mac, Alt on a PC. Hold down the Alt or Option key, grab this file and drag it, and it creates a duplicate. Now, I didn't let go of Option until I duplicated it. I let go with my mouse, and now I can let go of Option or Alt, and it's duplicated it. So now I can put one on top if I want to, and I can have other ones fade in. I'm going to select this one. Since it's an exact duplicate, I'm just going to, since this one is basically the duplicate here, I'm going to select it. I'm going to go up to the edit screen here, select, actually, instead of winter times, let's make this springtime. Select my arrow, and we're going to move this up here, and then I'm going to get rid of my summer times and duplicate the small one that says springtime here. So we're going to duplicate that. Drag this down here, change the color to a nice spring color. Kind of greenish, hit okay. And now we'll make this one autumn time. Make that color maybe a little more reddish or orangish or something like that, kind of like the changing leaves. There we go. So now I've got the summer times and winter times graphic that fades in, and I've duplicated this one. I want this to fade in at a different time here. So it fades in those two, and then this one you'll notice down here will fade out and leave the spring and autumn time up. And you can just change the timing on these things, change the edit, move it around as you wish. Well, that's it for this episode, everybody. Thanks for watching. In the next episode, I'm going to be going over the track select forward and track select backwards tool. Thanks for watching, ChinFat, and if you have any questions or comments, please post them.